I hope you've all had a good New Year's and not too many headaches. And hope you're all fit and rare and get back to work. I go back on Wednesday and quite looking forward to it in a way. I've got a little bit bored now being at home, but it's nice being in the warm. This particular job, I think I videoed this in September, October time. It's a regular I do once a fortnight. It's basically a holiday home. It's all banking though, so I stream everything. There is one little strip you don't see near where I park my van, which is flat, but I stream that as well because it would take me longer to get the mower out of the van than it would me to actually cut it. So. And as a rule, it always seems to be wet when I cut this one. So streaming is an advantage on this. Some of you might be thinking I haven't got ear defenders or a face shield on. Basically, I've got earplugs in. I find them a lot more comfortable than ear defenders. And I've actually got impact glasses on. I tend to wear the darker ones most of the year. But as a rule, my impact glasses, I put them on when I get in the van in the morning. And I don't take them off until I get home night time. As you can chop a finger off and they can stitch it back on, but if you've only got one chance with your eyesight, so don't take any chances with that. As you can see, there's a ladder leaning against the tree there, and I sort of strim around it and try and get the trimmer underneath it. I don't move it. And as a rule of thumb, whenever I'm cutting lawns, mower or strimmer, I don't tend to move any garden furniture unless I have to. Purely over the years, the amount of wooden garden furniture that you move and it falls to bits, or it just goes all wonky and leg falls off or something, so I just don't touch it. I don't run the risk of being accused of breaking things, which most people are pretty good and say, yeah, but you can get the odd one. So that's why I avoid moving stuff in people's garden. As you can see, it's quite a slopey old garden. I don't have a guard on the strimmer when I do this one, and that's because I can run the line longer, meaning I can cut it quicker. But what I do is I actually run a thinner line on the strimmer, so there's less stress on it. So instead of running, I think it's normally a 2.6, I think. I only put a 2mm line in, and I can cut this probably twice the speed I could if I was running with a normal line and the guard on. So that's why I put a smaller line in. It's less stress on the machine, but you get a wider cut. And like I say, you know, I take the guard off. Some places I always get the guard on with a risk of stones etc. hitting me, but as I said, I've cut this for quite a few years now, you know, 2 years. I know the grass is, I know where I'm safe on it. Apart from that bit of bloody cord line, I think most of us hate cord lines. It wraps up around the strimmer, or even the lawn mowing that'll wrap up around the blade. So, So I hope you've all had a good Christmas and had a good rest. And I hope you all have a good 2017 and a very profitable one as well. Thank you for watching.